Hello awesome people of YouTube and welcome back to game number 5 between our Finland players and German players. This again is going to be ShoWTimE versus Welmu. I'm not sure why these guys are playing again. Now in the last game, I hope you've already seen it. If not, you might want to go back before I spoil it. And I'll give it a few moments. So we're going to be continuing on. So as I said previously, there is no best of whatever amount that the player has to do. It seems to be whenever a player gets knocked out, he's gone from the series and a different one takes his place until he knocks out the until either he gets knocked out himself or he knocks out the next player. So gonna be starting off pretty standard here. ShoWTimE versus Welmu. Does it appear that Welmu is interested in an expansion first? Now spoiler is here now. So basically in the previous game, Welmu actually took the game because they both started off exactly the same, but then there was a bit of a deviation in Welmu's build. He decided to go for a robotics facility quite early after basically ShoWTimE tried to rush him with pylons and overcharges. Didn't quite work out. So what happened was Welmu built a robotics facility, and with the help of about 2 or 3 immortals, he pretty much dominated ShoWTimE's stalker army. So this is going to be game number 2. I really am wondering if there's going to be game number 3 between these two players. As I said in the past, I don't preview any games at all. If they turn out to be absolutely ridiculous, which seems to be about 50% of Zerg games so far, then I will not upload it. If it is, then of course I will upload it, because why not? Now, you have to do a mirror matchup from of every sort every now and then. Protoss versus Protoss, of course, is one that you don't see very often, which is very strange. One of the most common ones that I see is Terran versus Protoss, to be honest. That's one of the biggest matchups that I'm seeing so far. And one of the ones I want to see the most of is Protoss versus Protoss. Simply because last time, I remember I watched a game, or casted a game, of ShoWTimE versus Probe. And my god, was ShoWTimE's performance in those absolutely beautiful. I could not believe how well he did with his disruptors. So this map is actually a lot bigger than Ulrina. Dusk Towers has a lot of expansions, a lot less gold expansions. As you can see, there is only one on each side. And that is pretty much it. So, gonna be able to see how this progresses. Does look like there's a stalker coming out for... I have to change the things again. So ShoWTimE is at the bottom. There he is now. Stalker has been taken out for him. Second one on the way also. And it does look like Welmu is interested in Adepts instead. So in terms of damage, I do believe that Stalkers win versus Adepts. But at the same time, Adepts are pretty tricky to catch onto. Now they both do 10 damage actually. But I think the Adepts have a little bit less armor. So yeah, there we go. Or shields rather. So yeah, I think overall a Stalker will probably win versus an Adept. Let's check the attack speeds as well. Yeah, definitely would. The attack speed is a lot in favor of the Stalker. So he would be able to take on one, not two though. Just decides to ignore these two. So this is a bit of a tough situation now. He doesn't know which one he should attack. They're going to just warp straight in here. There we go. Starts to take on a few probes. Going to probably overcharge this pylon. There we go. Starting to do a bit of damage. This one Adept going to get destroyed very, very quickly. Second one also probably going to lose his life. Or her life rather. And one more hit. And there we go. Does manage to take out 4 probes with that. So a little bit of economic damage has been done. I want to have a quick look at the income tab. It does appear that Welmu is favoring a little bit here. He did put up the expansion earlier. So he's got this fully saturated already. Now, 2 more gases coming out, which suggests to me he might be going for a bit more tech-heavy build right now. Has an Observer out and probably will have Immortals out very shortly after that. I mean, they single-handedly won the game for him last game, so wouldn't be surprised if he tries to do that again. ShoWTimE, of course, has his own robotics facility on the way. Very standard here. I would expect to see Immortals out of him a lot sooner in this game, though. Simply because last time he pretty much lost straight out because he didn't have any. Now, as you can see, there is Blink almost complete for him as well. ShoWTimE very fond of his Blink Stalkers. He's also quite fond of Disruptors, which unfortunately we haven't seen in this line, in this matchup yet. But a full-on Stalker versus Stalker army will always deserve to have Disruptors in the back of it. Simply because Disruptors, even though Stalkers are fairly beefy units, Disruptors do indeed one-shot Stalkers. What is this? 2 more gateways being thrown down. Ooh, that's actually a total of 6 gateways being thrown down, so that's important. There we go, actually Zealot Legs being made here from Welmu instead of Blink, which is a very odd choice if you ask me. ShoWTimE, why are you not trying to kill one probe? Kill one probe! Yes, at least he manages to take one with it. Not a complete waste coming down here. Gets a bit of scouting information, gets a bit of kill. So, oh, this disruptor, or this observer, not going to get killed by anything. Does ShoWTimE have an observer? He does indeed. But not killing it. So this observer is going to be very difficult to spot, unless of course it moves over buildings, a lot easier to see then. Now these players have a very trained eye for these kind of things, he would be able to see this very, very easily. There we go, now he does see this observer, going to try to catch it out. He does have blinks, so there we go. Now taking it out. Now let's look at the army tab, it does appear to be favoring, this is showing the other way around. Okay, this is really annoying, the way this is showing Welmu's army on the left hand side, not on the right hand side, but that's okay. We're going to get over that. But it does appear that Welmu's army is favoring. He has 2 immortals in the army. Ooh, ShoWTimE finally bringing out the robotics bay. So could potentially see some disruptor play. And I really hope that we do, because ShoWTimE is so, so good with his disruptors. And keep in mind, Welmu does not have blink right now. So this could be the deciding factor between these two players right now, the fact that disruptors, if he does manage to get them out on time, which it very, very well looks like he's trying to delay until then, he's trying to put up a few pylons which he'll be able to overcharge. His mothership core does have full energy, so definitely will be able to. He also has himself blink, which it doesn't appear that Welmu has. He has zealot legs instead, so these zealots will be able to get in there very, very quickly. But the disruptor being produced here is going to start chrono boosting it out. He's going to have to overcharge here and hold on. There's 3 archons also in this army, a huge amount of damage going off. It does appear that Welmu's army is getting very quickly cleaned up, simply because it's mostly ground units. And there we go, they engage again. One archon getting taken out very quickly. All the zealots just streaming in here, but so many overcharges going down. The disruptor just about to come up. Is it going to be here on time? It is indeed. It's on the way now. Going to be able to take a huge chunk of units out with that disruption. Yes, purification over going down right on top of the archon. Didn't actually one shot it, of course, but instead does bring it down to pretty much only health left. And there we go, the cleanup starting to happen now. This is quickly going to start favoring ShoWTimE, because of course he has more units here. Does look like the immortals also getting taken out, getting chased by the stalkers, probably not the best of ideas, but is fully able to clean this up, and he will be able to chase all of this down very, very easily. So there you go, a cleanup by ShoWTimE, now starting to favor also in the supply. Very, very well played here. The disruptor didn't actually take as much health as I thought it would be. It only hit an archon there, as far as I can see. Oh, Welmu actually GG's out. That's quite interesting. So he did recognize that he's so far behind right now. Look at this. Did I miss something? There was 48 supply for him there. Okay, no, I hadn't missed anything there. It just simply that the army was wiped out and 48 supply was what was left with the workers. So that's pretty much it. It does appear that Welmu actually gets knocked out in this case. So next game is going to be between ShoWTimE and Serral. I see you guys in game number 6. And of course, if you haven't subscribed already, the game will be released shortly, and do subscribe to be able to be notified of when it's up. See you guys next time. Good luck. Have fun. Take care.